would codify the previous federal pre-tax deduction of up to $230 per month from folks' salaries for transit, vanpool, and parking expenses.
Any discussion? Want to move the bill? Bill is moved. Yeah, this bill is going to go to?
The floor.
The floor. Third reading. Next bill.
Senate Bill 4241 by Senator Larkin would allow roadside farm stands to obtain a license to sell wine from up to two farms or specialty wineries or micro wineries located within 20 miles of such licensed roadside farm market.
Any discussion? That was reported.
Brother, just to clarify, 2722 is going to first reading.
Right? Correct.
Okay. You're absolutely right.
4246 by Senator Little would direct the Commissioner of Taxation and Finance to provide a single line upon which to enter all contributions that are currently lined out on the personal income tax form. This bill is referred to Finance.
Any discussion?
I think it's a positive bill and also allows us to expand this list in the future.
Yeah. That's the primary reason for it. Next bill.
Senator Nozzolio's 4431 would designate sweet corn as the official state vegetable.
We got back to the dispute between sweet corn. What was the other one, the onion?
The onion.
Onion. Okay. Move the bill.
I will spare us all commentary. I'll say simply I'm voting without recommendation on this at this time.
Do you have a favorite?
You know, I believe Wayne County is the highest or second highest producer of sour cherries in the country.
Sour cherries? That's good. I think that one of the
that would be a state fruit. We have a state
that's
fruit.
A good
the apple.
That's
so.
Good.
We can't change the apple one.
That's right. We could call it a vegetable and move on.
Actually, probably could. Next bill.
It's a two bill.
Senator Martin, 6079A, would exempt libraries from the imposition of the Metropolitan Commuter Transportation Mobility Tax. This bill is referred to Finance.
Chairman, if I could just say that I really want to commend Senator Martins for introducing this bill. It's very important for my district to have a lot of libraries that have been burdened with this MTA payroll tax. It would be much needed relief for them. It would be a good continuation of our effort that started in June, continued in December, and I'm strongly supporting it.
The reform of the MTA payroll tax to create some additional exemptions in December. I think answered one issue in the state, but with doing it without additional MTA funding is one that raises concerns. Having done it, expanding it to libraries, I think is something that I can't oppose. I think that some of the exemptions that were in the reform of the MTA payroll tax in December make sense, including this one does. One concern is that reform created a freelancer's penalty where, in effect, small businesses get taxed at a lower rate for the MTA payroll tax than freelancers do because of, I think, just a technical way that bill was written. So I'd like to see continued updates to that reform happen. I'm going to vote yes on this in order to have consistency. As long as we're doing this, we should include libraries. I'd like to see us include freelancers in the future, too.
I think this is a gradual step-by-step approach. Moving through all of the entities that are presently covered by the MTA tax with the intent that Senator Zeldin points out to get rid of the tax entirely. That is the intent of all these bills. I think Senator Martins also has something coming in a press conference on villages as well, exempting villages from the tax as well.
As towns and counties, I think, are covered by his legislation.
And I hope the majority will join me in doing the same for freelancers and also finding a sustainable source of funding for the MTA.
Yeah, that's
simply doing
yes.
away with it from your head in the sand.
Well, that's the whole point. We're in consultation. That's why it's being done step by step.
And thank you, Chairman, for moving this bill as quickly as you are.
Bill is reported to Finance. Last most important bill of all.
6195 by Senator Marcelino would extend for 1 year the current authority for the State Liquor Authority to issue temporary retail permits until the final retail permits are issued by the authority. This is referred to Finance.
Discussion.
And just briefly vote without rec on this. It's a laudable goal, and I believe I did vote aye on the floor in the past. The ability to extend endlessly for the agency without sort of having to go back to a community board, for example, in New York City, is a concern here. And I'd like to see that modification made. So I understand the laudable goal. chairman, but that would help. I'll go over that rest today.
Bill's reporting to finance. Being up for the business, I move the committee adjourned. Thank you.